Well, construction workers, landscapers, and small business owners standing up against Florida's new immigration law. And this morning, a massive protest is planned in downtown Fort Myers.
So that march is going to start at Centennial Park and then end at El Nuevo Maguey Bar and Grill on Palm Beach Boulevard. As you can see on this map, Palm Beach Boulevard is going to be shut down. The Lee County Sheriff's Office, along with Fort Myers Police, will have extra security in that area. We have team coverage this morning. Traffic anchor Rachel Cox Rosen has ways for you to get around this, avoid those closures. But first, let's start with reporter Asha Patel standing by at Centennial Park with the impact of this new law. And Asha, what's the mindset of the protesters ahead of the march?
Lindsay, their mindset is they're not going to let this Florida heat stop them. They said that they are going to walk the 4 miles. They're going to have 6,000 to 7,000 people join them. And organizers say if they don't do this now, a lot of people that we see working in grocery stores, restaurants, and in farms are going to have a direct impact, as this is one of the strongest anti-illegal immigration laws in the country. Take a look at this photo from the governor's office. This is what's included in the law, and you can see right at the top, this is one of the strongest anti-illegal immigration laws in the country. It goes into effect July 1st and will require businesses with 25 or more employees to use E-Verify to check the employment eligibility of employees. Employers who fail to use E-Verify will be fined $1,000 a day. It also suspends the license of any employer who knowingly employs an illegal immigrant, and hence this penalties for human smuggling provides $12 million to continue the unauthorized alien transport program, bans local governments from issuing identification documents to illegal immigrants, and requires hospitals to collect and report health care costs for illegal immigrants. Now, we spoke to Irma Bautista, one of the organizers of the protest, as well as a 15-year-old who was participating in the demonstration, and both say it's crucial that their voices are heard today.
It's really inspiring to see, like, my grandma, my grandpa's participating in this stuff. Like, it's just inspiring because they're standing up for themselves and a whole bunch of other people.
If we don't do nothing about this new law, SB 1718, if we don't do nothing, we're all going to be affected. And it's very sad. A lot of families can be very affected. And what our whole group is thinking is it's going to hurt children. Children that do not have a voice.
Now, the plan is for everyone to gather here at Centennial Park at 10, and they are going to start here, and then they're going to walk 4 miles to El Nuevo Maguey, a restaurant on Palm Beach. And the organizers say that an ambulance will be here, and there will also be food and drinks on hand to make sure that people are hydrated and safe while walking through this heat today. Now, Lee County and Fort Myers Police Department will be also assisting with road closures and security during this protest. But for now, I'm live in downtown Fort Myers. Asha Patel, Link News.